morning, Green Spring. It is Thursday, March 21st. Welcome to the first full day of spring. I'm Elke Martin, your host, and we have a guest in the studio whom you may have seen before. She's been around Green Spring for a good while. Rachel Baker. Good morning, Rachel.
Good morning.
You are working in the intermissions program. That's right. You are here to tell us about what that means, and you are going to tell us about dance and movement, right?
That's right. Yes.
So what is it that you all do in intermissions?
So intermissions is a wonderful program. We bring in the creative arts therapies to help with residents here, and we run Monday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. I'm a dance movement therapist in the program. Our program coordinator, Amy Hughes, is a music therapist. Mm-hmm. And we run a lot of fun activities also. We'll bring in art projects, some cooking projects, therapeutic games, and every day is different. So.
That sounds interesting, yeah.
It is.
And I see you, so I think you're down here in Village Square quite a bit?
That's right. This is our gathering place, and then we go down to the tea level of Forest View for our actual meeting room.
Okay. Yeah. And can anybody sign up, or whom is this geared towards?
We're geared towards residents who might be looking for a little more structure in their days here, maybe someone who's looking for a little more support. A lot of our activities during the day have a cognitive focus, so maybe someone who might notice their memory is not quite what it used to be, and they want some more support around that.
And it's all entertaining, it sounds like.
It is. We try to be.
Yeah.
We have a different theme every day of the week to keep it interesting and fresh.
And I saw behind your name, you have this alphabet soup.
I do.
B, C, D, M, T. What does that mean?
Board certified dance movement therapist.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to grad school for my master's degree in dance movement therapy. And then I worked for a few thousand hours after that, much of that here at Green Spring, and got my board certification just last year. So.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
And so dance therapy, that sounds like a lot of movement. I don't quite see that here, is it?
It can be. I always say, and part of why I wanted to come on here is to say that there's no need to be intimidated by it. So sometimes we might get up and do the jitterbug or a little disco. Sometimes we might do more seated meditation. But whatever we do, it's geared towards all levels of ability and physical preference. I know not everyone loves to dance, although a lot of people do.
Yeah, particularly when you are not in an environment where you are shy. But I've also seen in your group a few people with walkers, rollators, and in a wheelchair, so they can still participate?
Completely, yes. We often do seated activities, but sometimes we do get up, but everything we do, you can either take to a higher level or bring down to what your needs are.
So. Oh, without feeling that you can't do it. You can still participate. That's good.
That's what I like about it, is that it really focuses on what everyone can do versus what you can't do.
And you brought us a big box here of something, so show us, tell us.
So I'll usually start each dance movement therapy session with some gentle stretches to warm up our bodies and get used to moving. And then from there, I'll turn into what our theme of the day is. So it might be exploring, say, a little soft shoe tap dance, or it might be exploring the theme of spring. Or we might break out some of our props or connective tools, some of which I have here. So this is our parachute.
Oh, looked like a sleeping bag to me.
Yes.
Parachute.
Kind of that type of bag here. And it can just be fun to play with and just explore what different movement opportunities it might bring. See if I can get this the right way. So I've got a giant smiley face here. There, I think I found the eyes.
Oh, look at that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I can see what you mean.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so you have people sitting in a round?
Yeah, well, we usually sit in a circle and everyone can grab the edge. We might shake it out a little.
I see.
Or take turns balancing different things. And
uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And so eventually this turns into a big smile.
It does, yes. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. We need a few more people to fill it out.
Uh-huh. And then do you sing as you do this or not
sometimes,
so much?
Sometimes. It varies. Mm. But with Amy, our great music therapist, sometimes we can collaborate a little with music and movement.
Yeah,
and
I bet that's fun. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And if we're not singing ourselves, we do usually have music playing at least.
So yeah.
Makes it more fun.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So this
but
is
you,
one.
You only move this up and down. You don't do, or do you have
we can do a little
big balloons on top?
We do. Mm-hmm. We have balloons. We've got beach balls. We've got some foam baseballs that we can balance or pop up into the air.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And now beside it being fun, what is it good for?
It's good for connecting. So a lot of things that some people might struggle with is just becoming more isolated too, which is another reason our group is so important, because we're there as a group. So
you mean connecting me to you,
right? So
not
if I'm holding this and
balloon.
You're holding this, right?
Yeah.
Then it helps us relate more and have
and
that experience.
And probably people laugh across the
absolutely.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. That is always connecting. I see what you're saying.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And if you've got a giant smiley face, you usually can't help but smile and have a little fun.
Uh-huh.
So. Yeah.
Okay.
So this is one thing I've brought. I did also bring, let's see. Okay.
I hold it.
Thanks.
Ooh.
A few things. I'm like a
colorful.
Magician.
Colorful.
Very colorful.
Wonderful. I love it already.
So similar to the parachute, this is called an octaband.
Oh, this is one piece.
This is all one piece. And this is great. Each end has a loop on it.
Uh-huh.
And that can make it more arthritis friendly too, that you don't even need to hold on with your hand. You can just loop it over a wrist and or a foot or elbow, whatever.
Okay, I'm
inspiration
ready.
Strikes. And so this is another fun one, especially if you feel it, it's got a good tension to it.
Oh, you can stretch.
Yeah.
I just had this morning in my yoga class.
Oh, yeah, those stretch bands?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I guess it's good at any level of ability, right?
And I like this too. I know we're still a little while away, but this always reminds me of a maypole. So
a maple.
So May 1st, how?
Oh, a maypole.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So they have all these colorful bands, and they dance around the pole. Yeah.
So, a little preview of what's coming up. We'll turn this into a maypole.
What is this thing called?
An octaband, inspired by the octopus.
Uh huh.
And
yeah, it looks like it's alive for sure.
It does.
Yeah.
It's got a mind of its own. And then, related to the octaband, these are called the octaband links. And these are good if we've just got, say, two of us here.
Yeah.
If you'd like to take that end.
Yeah.
And I can take this end.
Okay.
And we can find ways maybe to pull or push-pull or lift it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah.
Give it a little shake.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Finding different ways to just express.
And again, to connect.
Right, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So you say that is an issue for people. Does that become more prominent with age?
It varies. It can for some, for others not so much. So, but that's another big thing that intermissions is good for, because we have a group that meets every day. So if someone is spending a lot more time in their apartment, we're a group that they can come to and feel comfortable in. And
now, when you sign up for intermissions, do you sign up for every day? Or could you say, maybe a little too much for me. I want to come Monday and Thursday or something.
Yeah, we recommend at least 2 days a week, but two are welcome, five are welcome. You can pick what works with your schedule the best. And we also do offer whole day and half day options. So someone would be welcome to come from 10 to 3 for the whole time, or for the half day, the morning goes from 10 to 1, and the afternoon goes from 12 to 3 with that lunchtime overlap.
Oh, you have an overlap there.
Yeah, so we all eat together and everyone can see each other at that time.
I remember some years ago when I worked here, we had a volunteer who always brought the food down from the restaurant to your offices. That's still going.
That is, and we used to eat downstairs, but we actually have moved upstairs to Woodland Skies now. So we eat in the dining room every day. And it's great to have
definitely a social hour.
It is.
Eating together for everybody.
Nice to have that time together.
And do residents who participate in this program use their meal of the day for that?
It is not the meal of the day. That's included in the program costs.
So I see.
It doesn't interfere dinner or someone's normal.
So that's completely separate.
Right.
Yeah. Do you want to talk about the program costs at all?
Sure. The half day option is $50 for that 3 hour time period. And then the whole day option for the 5 hours is $80.
Then that's per day.
Per day, right.
Yeah. And it doesn't matter whether you take the half day or the full day. It always includes the lunch, you said, right?
It does, right. Yeah.
And so for people who maybe are not fast in the morning and not early risers, they join you at 12 for lunch and then afternoon activities.
Right. We know some people like to sleep in, and we know others like their afternoon nap. So.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
And others
just
like
keep
to get going the whole day.
Okay. Well, thank you for all that information.
Yes.
So what is this?
This is the...
This looks like the old hair nets my mother had when she came from her perm.
Oh,
I remember those.
Do you have it covering?
Yes, exactly.
That's the other thing I really like about these is that they tend to evoke a lot of memories.
Yeah,
and
for
me, they also make me think of springtime with the flowers or a magician pulling the scarves out.
Yes.
So it gives us more chances to be creative.
And to what is it called? Reminisce, right?
Right.
And
just
talk about that. Yeah.
Yeah. It's important to have that time.
Important for?
For memory and also to connect and saying, oh, yes, my grandma would wear those hair nets.
Yeah,
finding those moments.
And this has a very different feel to it from the others.
It does, and if you give it a little toss, just kind of floats down.
Yes, yeah, and it pops open.
And kind of like how I was mentioning, some people like to dance, some people don't. Everyone's got these different movement qualities, so some people might connect more with a floating, more light quality, and others might like that tension, and, and that can change too. So it's nice to have these different ways to connect.
And, and different ways. So if you offer all these different things, then everybody is likely to find something. Right?
Exactly.
Okay.
Yeah. And I know the word dance can feel intimidating, but we can dance with this or dance with the scarves and. Feels less intimidating.
And people don't feel silly, or it doesn't matter. Maybe
it doesn't
matter.
Sometimes we feel a little silly, but it's always good to have a little silliness sometimes.
That's true. You just have to get over that hump.
And with the different levels, everyone's able to participate to their comfort level. So they could take this more seriously or sillier if they want to.
And people don't tend to laugh about each other, I'm sure.
No, it's a very welcoming
group. It's a safe environment.
Safe, and we have a very kind group.
That's good, yeah.
It is.
So you were going to tell us more details of some of the things you do, particularly pertaining to dance, right?
Right, yes. I'll say some of our goals with dancing can be finding that vitality again. So instead of, say, sitting in an apartment alone, we can connect and energize. Some more goals we have are that reminiscing and connecting. And they also talk a lot about, in current research on the brain, just the importance of physical activity along with that social connection and that cognitive stimulation. So mm-hmm. we find ways to bring all of that in for well-being. And, mm-hmm.
yeah. But you don't dance all day long, right?
Not all day long, okay. No. Just a glimpse of our daily schedule.
Yeah.
From 10 to 11 or so, we'll have some coffee and go over historical events, this day in history kind of a thing.
Uh-huh.
Then from 11 till 12, we'll have our first experience, and that might be a movement session, it might be a music session or a game. From 12 to 1, we'll have our lunch together. 1 to 2, we'll have our second big experience of the day. Might be an art project or a crossword puzzle or a bingo game. Mm-hmm. And then from 2 to 3, we'll break into smaller groups. So that way, people can focus more on what their interests are. So you might have some people working on a jigsaw puzzle together or mm-hmm. some people working on art projects or finishing projects that they had started but didn't have time to finish yet. And we'll have maybe brain teasers or crosswords or...
I remember I used to volunteer and do crosswords with the group many years ago, and that was always fun.
It is, you know,
it's also amazing to me sometimes how people who... Well, you're not sure how much they touch down right now, right here. Mm-hmm. You come up with crossword puzzle questions and boom!
Mm-hmm.
Remarkable, that must address a different part of the brain or so. I don't know. But
Those memories are still there.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And it's also nice to have a group to work together. So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And different people at different speeds.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And
so you said cooking shows? Cooking show, but cooking
projects.
Something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
For
real?
For real, yes. Mm. Yeah, we don't have an oven in our space, but we do have a microwave, we have a bread machine, and we'll also do some no-bake projects.
Uh-huh.
So I know a lot of people don't cook anymore, but it's something that a lot still enjoy. And
yeah.
remember doing and do well, so we like to bring that in.
You do no bake cookies or something that are real cookies and not with Play-Doh.
Right, yeah. Real cookies. We've done peppermint bark around the holidays. We've done Jell-O and pudding and no bake cheesecake.
Yes, so. I've eaten one of those once. That's
really good.
Yummy.
Mm-hmm. It is. Yeah.
Oh, that sounds like fun. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And it's nice when we have the bread machine going just to have the smell of baking bread. And,
Mm-hmm. Now, you told me before the show that you brought some music and you brought some movements in your mind that you want to show us so that you can introduce us to the dance and movement therapy. Do you want to do that now?
That would be great. Yeah.
Okay.
And I'll invite you to join in. And if anyone is watching at home, they're welcome to
follow along.
I do like to mention that you're always welcome to adapt anything you need to. So if you want to just sit back and rest at any time, that's fine. Or if you have more energy to bring in, that's fine. And if anything hurts, just be sure to listen to your body too and rest if you need.
Okay. So. Ready.
So we'll be pretty gentle here. So first I'll just share an example of the kind of warm-up that we'll do. So you can just feel your feet on the ground and support from the chair. And we'll take a nice deep breath in and slow breath out just to settle into our seats. I'll do a little head-to-toe stretch. So let's take a look over one shoulder and we'll take a look over the other.
Over the rainbow.
And we'll go to each side just one more time. And then you might drop your chin towards your chest. And we'll draw some half circles. Tracing from shoulder to shoulder. On your next one, you can bring your head up to the center. We'll take a gentle shoulder roll, either forwards or backwards.
Wake up where the clouds are far behind.
And we'll reverse the direction.
Where trouble smells like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where.
And on our next one, let's just shrug our shoulders up to our ears with a deep breath in. Hold that for a moment. The breath out, release. And let's take a reach up and over with one arm. Get a good side stretch. And let's switch up and over to the other side. And we'll come back and let's give our hands a little attention here.
Yeah.
Take a little wrist roll.
I know we do that for the feet.
Yes.
But for the hands.
We often ignore them.
Yeah.
Good to give them some love. And let's reverse, circle the other way. This can also be good if there's any stiffness or arthritis sometimes. A little gentle exercise can help. Let's take a little piano fingers here. And speaking of doing that movement for our feet, let's take that down to our feet here.
Oh.
Let's take either foot, we'll reach it out, take a little point and a flex. I'll take a roll with that ankle. And a roll the other way.
It's better with my tongue out.
Yeah. If it helps, go right ahead. We'll shake out that leg. And let that rest, and let's stretch out the other. Just angle so we don't play toesies here.
Thank you.
Take a little point and a flex. And I'll take a roll with this ankle. And we'll take a roll the other way.
Oops.
And we'll shake out that leg. And we'll let it rest. And then let's just take a nice big good morning stretch here. We'll take a deep breath in. You can reach your arms up. You can reach them out to the side or down. You're welcome to stretch your legs if that feels good. And we'll come back. Give everything a little shake out. And nice to have that movement.
Yes. So. Mm-hmm. It does wake you up, doesn't it?
It does, yeah. I don't know about you, but I know if I'm sitting for a long time, I'll get pretty drowsy.
Oh, yeah. So. Yeah. And, you know, it's not late in the day, so I've just gotten here woken up.
Yes. So we'll do that. Another benefit is that it helps to just decrease any muscle tension. So whether it's from sitting a lot or arthritis or from sleeping funny, maybe you have a crick in your neck, that can just help you relax, and that can help with balance, can help with getting an even gait when you're walking. And
So the last 5 minutes, you want to dance more than stretch?
I was actually thinking of leading a little bit of a meditation, if that sounds good. Unless you'd like to get up and dance.
No, it's your half hour. You tell us.
So for this, you're welcome to sit back, and I'll guide through a brief guided meditation. For this, you might start, if it's comfortable, finding one hand on your chest and one on your belly, taking the time to settle in with yourself. And you're welcome to close your eyes here or soften your focus. Whatever calls to you. You might notice your breathing here. You might notice where you feel your breath, if it's more in your nose, mouth, chest, belly, back. Then you might tune in with your heartbeat, seeing if you can find it today. Sometimes it's easier to tune in with than others. And as we sit here for a moment, you can just notice if any changes start to happen. Whether they happen or if things stay the same, either way is okay. Sometimes Just with a moment of rest, our breath will start to slow. Our heartbeat will calm. And you're welcome to rest your hands in your lap or the arms of your chair, whatever's comfortable for you. And you can feel your feet rooted into the ground, feeling the support. Also feeling the support and connection you have from the chair. Really coming into this moment. As it is spring, you might imagine that your feet are like the roots of a flower, reaching deep into the earth, supporting you. And you can stay with this image, or I'll invite you to imagine that your breath is traveling up all the way from your toes to the top of your head with each breath in. And with each breath out, imagine your breath traveling back down from the top of your head through your toes. Breathing in, breath travels up the body. And breathing out, breath travels back down. Continuing to breathe at your own rhythm. I'll invite you to think of something you're looking for in this day, whether that's some energy, whether it's relaxation, whether it's a little peace, some vitality, love, whatever it is that calls to you. As you breathe in, imagine that quality washing over your body. Maybe breathing in harmony. And then as you breathe out, see if your breath can take a little tension with it. Breathing in peace. Breathing out any tension. Letting each breath wash like a gentle breeze. Continuing to breathe on your own time. Maybe one more deep breath in and slow breath out. Really taking this time for you this morning. And we'll start to re-energize the body. You might wiggle fingers and toes. Maybe take a little wrist roll or ankle rock. Maybe rubbing your hands together, get a little warmth. And you might take another stretch if that calls to you. Maybe taking a deep breath in, really tuning in with your body. You might let your breath deepen once more for one more deep breath in. And releasing the slow breath out. When you're ready, if your eyes were closed, you can let them open. I know it's good to move and also good to rest.
Wow. I think I woke up just in time to thank you, Rachel. This was certainly an interesting half hour, and thanks for coming by and showing us all your goodies and telling us about the intermissions program.
Thank you.
And we hope that if one of our listeners and viewers enjoyed what they saw, you probably know how to contact Rachel. If not, just go to your front desk and they'll connect you.